And to what's extraordinary complicated factor? Well, novelty, number, novelty, quantity, and complexity. Once customs decided to roll up the sleeves, they will apply, remember that reasonable suspicion standard to initiate the investigation. Here they will apply, instead of reasonable suspicion, they will apply substantial evidence. Meaning that if the evidence is substantial enough, they will make a conclusion that you are evade. It doesn't have to be beyond a reasonable doubt, such as in the criminal law, right? It doesn't have to be by preponderance of the evidence, which is like more than 50%, right? It has to be substantial. What is substantial? It's hard to put it in a percentage point. So this is the reason why we're going to take a look at some of the letters in a bit. But substantial evidence is another buzzword which I want you to be mindful of, because you see it throughout the Enforce and Protect Act. You see it throughout the Part 165 regulations. And customs examiners, they do like the buzzwords. All right. So affirmative determination, right? So that means that yes, the evasion does take place. So they will continue to suspend the liquidation of unliquidated entries. If liquidation is suspended, they will extend. So pretty much whatever was done in the interim will continue to take place until such liquidation. And once everything is done, right, then, and based on substantial evidence, customs finds that the evasion does take place, then there will be administrative presumption of evasion. Of course, you can go to customs court, to Court of International Trade, to prove the opposite. But that presumption will make adverse effects on your business. So you will be required to do the live entry. You will be required to place a cash deposit. You will be required to pay higher duties. So yeah. So negative. So customs may find that no evasion takes place. In that case, they will say, "Okay, we're going to withdraw, and the business goes back to normal." Of course, if there is any business that is left, you know that 300 plus 60, that's like a year, right? So you have to survive a year of scrutiny. And if that comes out all right, that means that you can resume in a normal course. Well, what if the year can be a long time for the business? So what if business does not survive? Can it resume in a normal course? Well, from the business perspective, probably not. But from the customs perspective, things go back to normal. All right. Notice of determination, 5 business day rule. After making determination, they will make information publicly available. This publicly available information can be easily seen on that main view page that I talked about, Enforce and Protect, not the checklist, the main page. So you have notices of actions, notice of final determinations right here. So anyone can click and see customs reasoning and rationale with respect to some of them. All right. Now, now I think it's time to take a look at some of the real cases which customs made their decision upon. So, first one comes the notice of non-initiations. Recall that. Notice of non-initiations, the reasonable suspicion prong, right? Customs takes a look at takes a look at the allegations submitted by the party, and they say, you know what, there is nothing reasonable about this. There is no reasonable suspicion standard. So in this case, we deal with the allegation by one company against another with respect to the steel pipe. It's particular steel pipe, circle well carbon steel pipe, which is being imported from China. Steel industry is one of the forerunners of taking advantage in of anti-dumping laws. It started earlier than others. It is more sophisticated and it is more protective than many other industries in the United States, and it's as far as anti-dumping law is concerned and countervailing duties are concerned too, it has a huge number of various orders standing in place that protect, insulate the industry and make it viable within the United States. So here you have an allegation that someone is trying to make a runaround and import the steel pipe from China, which is subject to the anti-dumping duties, right? So let's see. I just highlight the basic stuff. I'm not going to go through the whole letters because that will take forever. But basically, the company that made the allegation, they went to the public sources, and there is various data mining companies. Some of them like some of them is, one of them is like called DataMine. There is Panjiva. There is a whole list of data mining companies. And what they do is they collect data. How do they collect data? Well, they can buy data from customs. There is a provision in customs where you can get the business information, which is a proprietary information, deleted. So you are not going to get information like on pricing, but you can get the information in HTSUS. So of course, companies can limit that, and many do take advantage of that by filing what's called manifest confidentiality request. But irrespective of that, there is still data which is disclosed to the public. So those companies would go to customs and they would purchase this data from customs. Customs will provide this data. They would use their technologies and scripts to put this data in the context, and this will allow people who would like to analyze whether or not possibility of evasion takes place. This will allow them to draw some conclusions with respect to that. So this is what they've done, so they did some data digging, and they compared and contrasted, and they concluded that there is a possibility of evasion by looking at the numbers from the aggregate numbers using this next tracker database. They did some analysis, and they said, listen, there is a reasonable suspicion that those guys are not paying anti-dumping duties because the volume of imports for this particular product, this particular pipe, is not consistent based on our calculation. So without going into the details, customs recite the law, so they will initiate an investigation upon a reasonable suspicion. And here is the conclusion they say. So allegation reasonably suggests that Nextracker imported merchandise from China that may be subject to ADD. So they say, okay, they bring tube pipe, which may be subject to ADD, right? But may not be subject to ADD. The allegation of your data mining, of your data analysis allegation, does not reasonably support, right? Does not reasonably suggest that merchandise was entered through evasion. Evidence of importation, so we will say, okay, these guys imported so much, and they, based on their so much imports, they should have paid so much duties, but in fact, they paid so much duties, and some of the line numbers they drew from the whole numbers. So they did their math, right? So customs did not, in this case, find the methodology provided by the alleging party as particularly persuasive, because evidence of importation without more is not sufficient to raise reasonable suspicion. So, all right. So remember, I told you about those prongs. Like, what is a reasonable suspicion? What does it mean? Well. We know of one thing that what it doesn't mean, right? If you just bring in the evidence of importation, you without some kind of more information to back it up, that's not good enough. No evidence beyond its mere supposition to really suggest that next tracker entries were made by material false statements or acts. So this is one notice of non-initiation, which did not go through. This one did go through. This one relates to diamond saw blades. Notice the how different it was. So you had a saw blade, diamond saw blades, which are subject to the anti-dumping duty order. You had the importer of diamond saw blades. So they showed the party that made the allegation, they showed, yes, import did in fact take place. But instead of relying on the big data and providing this analysis, they went further and they said, hey, look, prior to imposition of anti-dumping duty order, this entity imported X amount of saw blades. After the imposition of anti-dumping duty order, this entity stopped importing those saw blades, at least on paper, and instead they decided to import some other product, quantity of which was very much like diamond saw blades, but they were classifying it as something else, thereby making an end run around and making a possibility of anti-dumping duty evasion. Again, the standard is a reasonable suspicion. So they classified diamond saw blades as millstone products in order to avoid the payment. And millstone products, they are not subject to anti-dumping duty, while diamond saw blades are. The importer began misclassification scheme when ADD, cash deposit rate, for diamond saw blades increased. Last imported circular saw blades was on this date. Then they started importing just about a month and a half later, different diamond saw segment, right? They decided to go to the public sources, such as public data mining. And they provided this data, right? In this case, it was Import Genius. And based on that, to raise the reasonable suspicion, they do not only go to Import Genius and say, okay, this guy imports diamond saw blades at this rate, so it's likely it's evading. No, they said, okay, this data suggests that they did get the diamond saw blades, they got it. They were paying this rate, and then the rate went up. So all of a sudden, they stopped importing diamond saw blades and started importing other commodities. But then, and they used public data sources to support that, but they didn't stop there. They didn't stop there. Let's take a look.